Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to connect the Chamberlain MyQ device to your OpenHAB 2 system. I personally use the Chamberlain garage door openers and use them to open and close my garage doors. If you want to control your garage doors, I highly recommend the Chamberlain MyQ garage door openers. The only thing we're going to need for this video is the Chamberlain MyQ device. I will leave a link to the Chamberlain MyQ devices over on my website. The link is in the description. But personally, I only use the garage door openers. For this guide, I am going to assume you already have the device installed and that it is running perfectly using the setup instructions Chamberlain provides, and you can control it from the Chamberlain MyQ app. I am also going to assume that you have a sitemap file, items file, and a rules file. If you do not, then go take a look at my video where I explain how to set up the configuration files in OpenHAB. I will not be making two separate videos using Mac and PC because the process is really similar. The only difference is that on Mac, you use terminal to SSH, and on PC, you use PuTTY. The first thing we have to do is SSH into the OpenHAB server. I recommend having my website guide open when you do this so that way you can just copy and paste commands. Link is in the description. Now we are going to go into the add-ons folder so we can download the binding into it. So type in cd /user/share/openhab2/add-ons and press enter. Then we're going to download the binding. So type in wget and this big link right here and then press enter. It should have downloaded the binding. The reason we are manually downloading it and not through the paper UI is because the binding in the paper UI is broken. I've tried it, it just does not work. Anyway, let's go back to the home directory. So type in cd and press enter. Now we need to restart OpenHAB 2 so that it can install the binding. Type in sudo /etc/init.d/openhab2/restart and press enter. Once it finished, type in sudo /nano /etc/openhab2/services/myq.cfg and press enter. This is the MyQ configuration file. It may or may not be blank. If it is blank, then paste in the following. The first thing we are going to do is change the refresh interval so it updates faster. Delete the pound symbol at the front of the line and change the refresh to 1000. Next, we are going to type in our MyQ credentials. So delete the pound symbol in front of username and type in your Chamberlain MyQ username right next to the equal sign. Then delete the pound symbol in front of password and type in your Chamberlain MyQ password right next to the equal sign. Please make sure that when you type in these values, you do not put in a space after the equal sign. Once those are typed in, press Ctrl X, then Y, and enter to save. Next, we're going to add the items. So type in sudo nano /etc/openhab2/items/home.items and press enter. Then type in the following. These are all the items that we have from the Chamberlain MyQ API. I made two sets of these items in mine because I have two garage door openers. If you have more than one like me, then you increment the MyQ number. It goes in order the way you added them into the app. So it starts off at 0 and continues on. I have 0 and 1, but if you only have one device, then you would just use 0. The funny thing is that I actually added garage door number 2 before number 1. So in my items file, I have it backwards if you are looking at the MyQ number. Also, I changed the item names to reflect which garage door they are for. So I put a 1 at the end of the ones for garage door 1 and a 2 for garage door 2. Once all those items are set, press Ctrl X, then Y, and enter to save. Now we're going to add all these items into the sitemap file, so we can see them in the interfaces. So type in sudo nano /etc/openhab2/sitemaps/home.sitemap and press enter. If you are following along with my videos, then you know we have a bunch of frames in our sitemap files. I'm going to put these items in the garage frame. So delete everything in the garage frame and paste in the following. Like I said before, I have two garage door openers, so I have two sets of these. Once those are all set, press Ctrl X, then Y, and enter to save. Let's test out what we have so far. Go into your web user interface and then basic UI. If you scroll down to Garage, you will see all the stuff for the garage doors. This is great and all, but there's still one more thing I want to do, and that is get notifications regarding the garage doors. So go back to the SSH window and type in sudo nano /etc/openhab2/rules/home.rules and press enter. Then type in the following code. Since I have two garage doors, I'm going to paste it in two times and modify accordingly. Let me explain what this rule does. It sends a notification when the door opened and closed, as well as send a notification if the door has been open for more than 5 minutes. The reason I did the 5 thing is because sometimes when people drive out of the garage, they forget to close it, so this just provides a friendly reminder. Once you are done, press Ctrl X, then Y, and Enter to save. That is it. The Chamberlain MyQ garage doors have been set up, so let's go test it. Alright, as you can see, I am in front of my garage, and in my hand I have a mobile device that is connected to the OpenHAB 2 servers using the OpenHAB mobile app. If you haven't seen it, make sure you check out that video. I show you exactly how to connect a mobile device to your OpenHAB server. Anyway, let's test garage door 1, and as you can see, if I press the up arrow, the door opens. Now let's do the other door. As you can see, if I press the arrow, it also opens. Next, I'm going to press the down arrow for garage door 1 and garage door 2. And as you can see, after 15 seconds, they are going to close. The reason you have to wait 15 seconds is because of safety. Chamberlain implemented this safety thing where it beeps and flashes for 15 seconds to let people know it is closing. It only does this when you do it from something other than the wireless remotes. Anyway, as you can see, it all clearly works, and when we did all of this, we are getting notifications at the bottom of the screen. Great! The device is connected and working. Now we can control this Chamberlain MyQ device from our OpenHAB system using either a mobile device or any of the web user interfaces. In the next video, we will be connecting the Amazon Echo to OpenHAB. Alright, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below, or head over to the MKSmartHouse.com/forum, where you have a better chance of it getting answered. Goodbye!